meteorologist Michelle Kennedy is standing by as we are looking at some snowstorms moving into our area. Michelle.
Yeah, we are talking about that winter storm concern and a lot of folks wanting to know, okay, how much snow are we going to get? The question is, where will you be as that high intensity snow may be falling? There could be some higher totals than the 1 to 3 inches that we are showing you for a swath of the northern Piedmont and parts of the Triad and foothills. We do think that there will be some folks who might only see a little bit. And it does look like the best snowfall possibilities and totals will still be in the mountains. We're looking at anywhere from 3 to 6 inches, and you get higher amounts as you go higher in elevation, about 4 to 8 inches. And really, if we're a little bit farther south too, we might see a little bit more. The system is so far south. We're looking at the 1 to 3 inches of snow mixing in. And what this means is it's going to be more of a big travel concern for everyone. So there will be some folks who could make a snowman. It's going to be hard to sled on that big, wet, heavy snow. But we can guarantee that we're going to see some slick spots on those upper elevated surfaces, anywhere that's going to cool as we cool throughout the day tomorrow. So we go into this warm. Most of the main roads will be okay for a little while, but if that storm does bring in that rain snow mix and possibly a little bit of sleet mixing in, it could get very messy very quickly. So slushy concerns, black ice, all of this sets up because we have temperatures that are going to cool and stay cool for most of the day. You might see some variation there from the low 30s to the upper 30s and then drop you back down into the 20s by early morning on Saturday. So we're going to be cold enough to support lots of travel trouble that will extend into early Saturday morning. So that's really the main takeaway. I know the kids are really loving the idea of seeing snow and maybe a chance to sled. I think that is still a borderline for many folks, especially Asheboro and Point South and East, where we're going to see more rain likely than snow initially, and slippery road conditions will be with us. Plus, some power outages might be possible if we can get that wind up, and we do expect it to come up. So that's what it's looking like right now. Good portion of the viewing area could see that mix come in, and we've got the heavy, wet snow for some. Others can just see the rain and snow, and that's very messy too, because if we see that refreeze overnight, or the roads haven't had a chance to clear, or some of that brine might have been washed off, we're in trouble, right? So several inches of snow will be possible for many out to the west, but impacts on travel and then those spotty power outages, hard to target. Very similar to what we talk about when we talk about scattered showers and thunderstorms. I want you to think of this event very similarly. We can't pinpoint always exactly where that storm is going to bring you the worst of the weather, but we do know the areas. And so most of the area that you see in the pink there, that's where we have that winter storm warning. So snowy conditions developing for folks in the mountains. You might even flirt with a chance of seeing some sleet mix in and snow covered road, plus some visibility is reduced, although your winds will not be as high as they will be east. And at times throughout the day tomorrow, if we get those winds backing off a little bit, your temperatures could rise. And that's what we have for you in the foothills. You see those temperatures kind of warming up to about 37 degrees. While meantime, winds may be stronger out in the Piedmont Triad, keeping you in the mid 30s and keeping you in a more likely scenario to see snow, but not ruling out that rain off and on throughout the day in between those big wet snowflakes. So what we see on the ground for snowmen, not necessarily a good indicator of what we're going to experience on the roadways. So I want you to be prepared. You can see this is developing overnight, and I think this timing looks pretty good. We're already seeing the atmosphere primed with some showers right now. We get a punch of that moisture overnight. It starts to fall. Not all of this on the ground at first. Of course, you're looking at those temperatures trying to cool at the surface. Remember, it's cooling aloft too. You might even get some sleet mixing in. Once you hit the sleet and that rain or snow combination, it gets so slick on our roads. And if we especially expect to see the accumulating as it continues through middle of the day, this is going to be a tricky travel day for most of us. You can see the snowfall totals could be coming up higher in some spots if we can keep that consistent snow going for parts of the central triad. So you're going to want to check back with us as we look at that very carefully over the next 12 hours. And Chief Meteorologist Lenny Pope is going to have more on how those models are changing and varying as we get you into this evening. But right now, we do expect the higher totals for now to come into the mountains. We're looking at 43 degrees in Winston-Salem, 43 in Greensboro, and our temperatures continue to cool. Those possible snowfall totals with our HRRR suggesting some high totals in just a few spots. So it could be very spotty where we get some high amounts. Other folks are looking at those lower totals and maybe just a trace. You can see another forecast model suggesting the northern Piedmont could be part of our have-nots group. All right, we're going to be looking at this closely over the next several hours. We'll be updating you online too. All right, your 7-day forecast, we'll get to you right now, showing you that those temperatures are going to be bringing in the sunshine and 40s for Saturday. So once we see the sun come up, it's going to have a big impact on getting rid of that melt and icy concern on the roadways. Both Saturday and by Sunday, you're at 45 as well and looking good.